guys, so I am making this video because I am now 5 weeks pregnant. It's still crazy to even say that. It doesn't even feel real. I've only known now that I have been pregnant for a week, so it's still really new. And it doesn't really help that I'm not having many symptoms either. So at 5 weeks, according to all of my apps and research, the baby is now a size of a sesame seed or an orange seed. I've heard different things, but it's growing a little bit. Supposedly it's starting to form its organs this week. Its heart will start beating soon and it starts looking a little bit more like a baby. Before, on the pictures that I saw, it just looked like a circle. And now it's kind of forming a more oval shape. So that's really exciting. I wish I could see everything happening in my body as it goes. I can't even feel the changes. All I can do is watch the videos and see what the baby supposedly looks like. So it's a little tough. Since I first found out I was pregnant, I did a lot of research. If you know me, I do a ton of research, especially with pregnancy. I've never really, obviously I've never had any of this before, so I didn't know, you know, what's the first step to do. So of course, what do? You Google. So I Googled, what do I do? And they said, schedule a doctor's appointment. So I took a, that was Felix. You can see him down there. Anyway, so I did a ton of research and I had to find the best doctor and the best facility, and it was really hard. Thankfully, here in Columbus, there's a ton of great facilities to choose from. I was choosing between two, and I ultimately made my decision because it's more near where I am. So I ended up picking that one, and the doctor that I picked, I wanted a girl. Not that I'm gender stereotyping or anything like that, it's just I felt I would feel more comfortable. I've always had a girl doctor. So I picked a doctor. I looked on reviews and everybody said she was really great and her picture looked really great. I know that sounds silly, but to me, pictures make a big difference. I was really curious thinking about this earlier. How did you guys pick your doctor? Did you go off a picture? A friend told you? Somebody I was talking to said that they picked their doctor because they had the same name as them. You know, I'm just always curious, like, what is it? For me, it's kind of pictures and how a person looks. Do they look nice? So, yeah, so I called and scheduled an appointment, and they don't want to see me until I'm at least 8 weeks. Well, since I'm 5 weeks now, it's another 3 weeks away, so it's really tough to wait that long, but I guess I'll just have to wait. They said that they'll be doing, hopefully, an ultrasound and probably make me take a test to prove that I'm pregnant, blood tests, and I'm sure they'll tell us, you know, what we should be doing. Any questions that I have, which I'm sure, knowing me, I'll have a ton of questions. Thankfully, Anthony is able to come to the appointment. He's going to take half day off work, which I'm really excited about because right now he's the only one that knows that I'm pregnant. And so I would hate to go to that alone, and it's really hard not being able to tell anybody or talk to anyone about it because it's such an exciting time and I have so many questions, and I know my mom and Anthony's mom and, you know, a lot of people in my life who have been pregnant that I would have great talking to and they'd have great advice, but we're still gonna keep that a secret. I think we're really wanting to wait definitely until after the first appointment just to make sure everything is going great. And you know, cause I've read that especially with the first pregnancy, miscarriage is a definite possibility. And so I just wouldn't want everyone to get their hopes up just to have to tell them bad news. I'm doing everything in my power not to have that happen, but if it does, it's a possibility. Ethan and I are really excited, still adjusting to thinking that, oh my gosh, we're parents. I still don't believe I'm pregnant. I think since I found out and I told Anthony, I think I must have taken like 3 or 4 more tests because I just don't believe it. And a big part of why I don't believe it is because I don't have a lot of symptoms. And so I'm just like, am I really pregnant? The only symptoms that I've really been having is I'm a lot more thirsty than I have been. And so I'm drinking a lot more. And I'm also going to the bathroom a lot more, but it's hard because I don't know if I'm going to the bathroom a lot more because I'm drinking a lot more or because my uterus is growing and it's pushing on my bladder. I'm really not sure. A lot of these symptoms that I experience, I'm kind of like, well, maybe that is it. But then I think again and I'm like, well, maybe it's just because this, this, and this. So it's hard to tell what's a pregnancy symptom and what's just a regular symptom. Like, I'm tired some days. Like, I'm really, really tired and I go to bed early. But I think to myself, like, is that really a pregnancy symptom? Or is it more of you just have been working and you got up early and you're just tired, you haven't been sleeping very well? So it's really hard. So I haven't been sleeping all that great, especially in the morning. I'll wake up, and again, I'm not sure if it's a pregnancy symptom or not, but I will be nauseous. My stomach won't feel that great. And I'm not sure if it's just every time I wake up, like I think like, oh my gosh, I'm pregnant, and I get butterflies in my stomach, or if it's pregnancy and like, oh, my stomach's not feeling that great. Because I have a pretty strong stomach. And so I'm not sure if it's like, oh, it's pregnancy symptom, I would be puking right now if I didn't have a good strong stomach, or oh, it's just butterflies in your stomach. Also, I heard that nausea really doesn't start until week 6 or 7 or 8. So again, I get all of these confusing symptoms and I'm not sure which one is right and which one isn't. So I really don't have a lot of other symptoms that a lot of people experience. My boobs really don't hurt that much. I'm only tired at certain times. My emotions haven't been too bad. Sometimes people will really get on my nerves and I'll get really, really annoyed. But again, is that pregnancy or am I just irritable because I don't have sleep or because it's just my personality and people can get on my nerves easily? I don't know. So you can see I'm like, am I really pregnant? I mean, I don't even feel it. It's just hard right now in the beginning, especially because I don't have anyone to ask, do you feel these things too? I have Google and other YouTubers, but it's hard not being able to like ask questions and things like that. So it'll be good when we have our first doctor's appointment and they'll be able to answer more of my questions. I did hear that some women go through pregnancy and they really don't have any bad symptoms at all, and that it's just like a breeze for them. So maybe that's me. I mean, knock on wood, but maybe it's just too early. I really don't know, but I'm really excited. Anthony and I, we're silly. We're trying to think of names. You know, of course we don't know the gender, we don't know for a while, but it's just something we like to do in our free time. Anthony and I just celebrated our 1 year anniversary. And so one of the gifts, it was paper. That's what you're supposed to get each other for your 1 year wedding anniversary. And so I got him a book, a pregnancy book, about what to expect now that he's gonna be a dad. And it's like a pregnancy book, but it's more guy language. And so I'm hoping he'll read it. He does. I'm not gonna force him to. I just thought it would be nice. I'll probably read it, honestly. I just thought that would be something for him because obviously he's never been a dad either, so he doesn't really know what's going on. And I keep telling him, like, I'm 5 weeks pregnant. He's like, no, you're not. And I'm like, yes, because it's from my last missed period. And he keeps going, well, how do you know? It's really funny. He's like, well, no, you don't know when we conceive. And I was like, yeah, but they always do it until we get the ultrasound. And so he's not believing me, like, you're not 5 weeks, which I'm sure I'm not, because that's from the last missed period. And I ovulated, I'm sure, like maybe a week or 2 weeks after that. So maybe I'm only 3 weeks pregnant, 2 weeks, I really don't know. But it's funny to see him try to understand different things. And, you know, we'll get something and he'll be like, I'll be like, no, I can't have that. I can't eat that. And he'll be like, what? So at least one of us knows what's going on. I think the food has been really hard for me. And I just want to try to give the best chance to the baby that I can. And so I've cut out caffeine as much as I can. I used to be a big time soda drinker. I would drink pop. You know, I'd buy pop. I'd have a pop a day. I drink it when we go out to eat. And now, ever since I found out I was pregnant, I haven't had any caffeine, no coffee, no pop. I've heard that a little bit is okay, but if you go too far, it could result in a stillbirth, or it could even result in miscarriage. And so I just don't even want to risk it at all. So I haven't been drinking anything like that, which has been hard because I really like pop, but it's for the best. Another hard thing is not eating cold cuts. I love sandwiches and Subway, and I mean, I didn't realize how much I love sandwiches until I couldn't eat it. So they say not to eat cold cuts because it's raw and not cooked. Cuts could affect your baby and just different things that could be hiding in there. So I'm not even gonna take that chance, and I'm just cutting that out completely as well. Another thing you're not supposed to eat while you're pregnant is a lot of different fish, which totally fine for me because I don't even like fish. So just planning out different things, not eating certain things, not drinking certain things. I don't like milk. I've never liked milk, but obviously it's great for the baby and the calcium and everything. So Anthony and I, we went grocery shopping and we bought some chocolate milk and to see if maybe that would be something. I mean, it's better than nothing. And I just had some earlier today, and actually I really liked it. It tasted like a Wendy's chocolate frosty. So I love it, and we're pumped that I have found something that milk-wise that I like. So I think we're gonna stick to that, and I'll just drink that, and hopefully that'll help. So I'm just trying everything I can. I've bought some pregnancy books myself. Of course, I bought the What to Expect When You're Expecting book. I was just like, why not? It's my first pregnancy. Everybody seems to have it. Can't hurt to do more research. So I've started reading a little bit of that. I also got a journal where I can like write down my symptoms and how I'm feeling every day. So I've been starting to fill that out a little bit. And so I'm really just starting to think how I want to announce my pregnancy to my family members and friends once Anthony and I feel comfortable with telling everybody that we're pregnant. So I've gotten it everywhere from, oh, maybe I'll pretend and take a picture and then yell, hey, I'm pregnant. Or maybe I'll just put on a card like baby Denzel coming. So I'm floating around a few different ideas, but we'll see. I can't wait to tell them though. It'll feel so nice not to have a secret. It's really hard because my sister Allison lives with us right now. And so I have to keep it a secret from her. And the other day we went out to a local tavern, and she was like, let's all get drinks. Well, of course, I'm pregnant. I'm not supposed to drink. And so I had to come up with some excuse like, no, I'll drive, I'll be the DD. And she was like, so you can still have one drink. And I was like, well, you know, I'm really lightweight and I don't want it to affect me even a little bit. I'll just wait till we go home. So she seemed to buy it, which I don't know if she did or not. I don't know if she expects something. I keep telling her every time she asks me that, you know, no, Anthony still hasn't told me yes. So I hope that she hasn't caught on yet. So we go back after dinner and she's like, okay, let's all get drinks. And so I was like, okay, Anthony, pour me a drink in my tumbler. And so Anthony just filled it with water and put some, Mio in. And I was like, oh yeah, this is rum. And I flavor it with Mio and it's really good. And so I just had to pretend that I was getting tipsy. So it stinks. Like it's stinks not getting to enjoy different things like that. Like in a couple weeks, Anthony and I are gonna go to Chicago and see Anthony's friend Corey, and a lot of that was gonna be like us going to the bars and drinking and different things like that, and now I won't be able to. Totally worth it. The baby's totally worth it, but it is just like a difference. Like I'm gonna have to change some things. So it is hard keeping a secret, especially because I have so many pregnancy things now. I've got my books and my prenatal vitamins, and I got lotion to prevent stretch marks and just different things like that. Now I have to hide it every time I leave because I don't know whether Allison's gonna see it or not. So it's really, really hard to keep it a secret. I did buy prenatal vitamins. They said it's very important, especially the folic acid, especially right now in the weeks that I'm in right now. I think they said up until week 10 is the most vital part because your baby's organs are all forming. I just got a generic brand. If my doctor tells me to get a different one, then I will. But the ones that are working right now are fine. I just have to take it with food, and I just take it every morning, and it's easy. And I did get lotion for stretch marks. I know, obviously, my stomach isn't going to start growing yet, but I don't even want a little bit of stretch mark. So I've just been putting it on every morning and every night, and it smells good, and it makes my skin smooth. So, I mean, why not? It's not going to hurt anything. I don't know if I'll buy some more things, maybe if they pop out at me at the store. But I definitely want to start buying some things just to like make announcements after we tell all of our close family and friends. Obviously we'll want to announce it like to all of our Facebook friends and online and things like that. So I have a couple ideas around of like how I want to announce that, and a couple things through Etsy that I might get to help me announce it. I love Etsy, and I love how you can personalize anything on there. So I just have a couple ideas floating around in my head, but right now it's just again trying to get it through my head that I am pregnant, because it just doesn't feel like it. Again, I don't have very many symptoms, and everything is kind of how it usually is. The world goes on, everybody has their normal lives, and I'm the only one sitting here in my head going, I'm pregnant. So it's hard when people are like, oh, what's new with you? And I want to say, I'm pregnant, but I can't. So I just say, oh, not much. Actually, a lot. So anyway, that is my 5-week update. I will show you a belly update. It's really not that much. I'm still really early on, and the baby is the size of a sesame seed, so obviously there's not much room being taken up, but I have been feeling bloated ever since I found out that I was pregnant. So that's something different that I don't usually feel. So let me just show you. As you can see, not much is new. It basically looks about the same. This is really just bloating, I think. So as you can see, there's really not much there. I mean, a little bit of a bump, but that's really just bloating. So it'll be exciting to see as it grows, as the baby gets bigger, and I can't wait to take you guys on this journey with us and update you week by week, and hopefully I'll have more to tell you next time, more symptoms, hopefully good symptoms and not bad symptoms. I'm really scared to get nausea and having to vomit everywhere. So hopefully that misses me, but we will see. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you soon. Bye.